Let's start about finishing of your project. So finishing of the project will start with cutting of the side, cutting of the edges. Like once your project is out, it will not be in perfect shape. It will be just like a raw thing. It don't expect it to be like perfectly. It will never be perfect. It will have up and downs, and you know, somewhere it will be, there will be a lot of, it will not be perfect basically. So all you have to do is, now we have to get rid of the imperfections. And I've already told you we are already, while making your mold also, while making the project, we are keeping some left, a space left. So I told you there has to be a cutting thing, where at the end always there will be imperfections. So that is the reason why we have to get rid of the edges now, and then the imperfection, there will be bubbles and everything will be at the end of your project. So all you have to do is you have to cut the edges now perfectly. See, because it was so much out, this project was so much out. So now we have just cut it accurately with the help of machines. So this you can starting you will not be so much expert. You can do it in table on the table saw, but you can either do it on table saw, or you can ask your carpenters to do it, or either you can go to your mills where you got your wood from. Reason being, it will be very hard to cut. It will be very strong, and it should cut accurately, absolutely straight. And only professional people like carpenters, they know how to cut it. The mill people, they know how to cut it because they have certain blades. And make sure, if you go to the mill also, please note this down. Make sure you ask them to use diamond blades because the mill people, they have certain blades which are used for hardcore things. The teeth of the blades, they are wider. So if they use that same blades to cut this your project, they will just end up chipping your project. It will not be accurate. It may also spoil because there will be a lot of chipping because their blade is a bit thicker. So always tell them to use this thinner blade, you know, like this sharp thin blade, which are called usually called diamond blades. Just explain to them, so because the regular blade, tell them not to use the regular blades to cut. Tell them to use this diamond blades, which are very sharp, but they are thin, and they will accurately cut it like butter. Your side will be cut like butter. So that is cutting the edges accurately. So you will just understand till what you need your project to be, because you have already kept extra spacing at the end. So now we'll be cutting accurately on the edges. And also when you cut with professionals and on the machines and all, you get everything accurate. There will be nothing big or small. It will be, if you are doing it in a perfect square, it will be perfect square. And one side bigger and one side smaller, it won't be like that. It will be absolutely perfect because these professionals will be cutting. And even if you are cutting it with the use of tools like tile cutter or whatever, so make sure you cut accurately. Just do your measurements and all, use your measuring tools and all, just cut it accurately. Basically now we are finishing it. Now everything should be accurate, absolutely perfect. Then after the cutting of the edges are done, now it is the process of smoothening the top surface. But the top surface will not be smooth now. It will have ups and downs, and there will be many humps now on top. In the beginning I told you we have to sand. We already sanded it, and everything is, the blade marks are gone, everything is gone. Now there will be, after your resin, after you get your resin done, everything is cured. Sometimes the level of the resin will be higher. Sometimes the level of the resin will be lower than your wood. So now all we have to do is get it into perfect shape. Perfect shape as in, we have to get it in this perfect harmony. See, look at this, it is perfectly perfectly in one shape. It is not the resin and this thing is in one and everything is smooth. See, so this is the process of leveling it, finishing it. Now we are going into the finishing part. So finishing part is done in a lot of ways, and this when we'll be doing our courses. The finishing course will be a very bigger course because it is a really vast course. Finishing can be done in a lot of ways, and there are lot of finishing. There are matte finishes, there are semi-gloss and gloss finishes, and the shape, the sides and all. Finishing is a very big topic in itself, because then you have to really know what you are doing. But I'll just explain to you the fundamentals. This is the fundamental that you have to know what you are looking for. So if you know this thing, you'll know what to do. Even if you'll be able to explain to your carpenters or whoever will be helping you, or even you can do it, because the tools and all which we use are really very easy to use now. And even kids they use this tool. It's very, they are all automated now. It's not like before. So now we'll be leveling the top and smoothening the top. So for that reason, there are a lot of options. First of all, I'll just give you a very easy and mechanical option, which is which can be done very easily. Basically, you have to just look for a CNC machine. CNC machine is widely available now. You just have to look for the CNC machine in your neighborhood. If you go to our Facebook sites or YouTube sites, we have all shown what is CNC machine, how it is used. You'll get the idea. If you don't have this idea of CNC machine, we've shown the cutting and all on our social sites. So you can just go and see for reference, or just remember that there is a machine called CNC machine, which is a very versatile machine. It is mostly used in doing a lot of shapes and a lot of other things. It is a big space actually, and there is a automated blade running here, running in straight accuracy. So the blade is revolving. It's a bead. It is a kind of bead. Bead as in there is rotation. The RPM, the high RPM, the blade rotates in like high RPM. There are certain blades to it, and it's like how the farmers use, how you shave and all. It is just removes layers by layer by layer. It is a machine. It's a very automated machine. So all you have to do is just take your project to the CNC machine and ask them to just get rid of a layer, which is 1 mm. You know, just you have to smoothen everything. There will be just 1 mm or 2 mm. You just have to get rid of the upper layer, a 1 mm layer. That will be easily done with that CNC machine, and that will give you accurate layer. So that will just, 90% of your job will be done there. Once you take it to a CNC machine, 90% of your finishing job will be done, because the machine will accurately get rid of the entire thing without even intense labor, and that will be a perfect job. We have our CNC machine. Before we used to do manually, now we do it in CNC machine to save time and to get more perfection. So this CNC thing, when we are using CNC machine, you have to use it on both the sides. First start from the bottom, just get rid of one layer of 1 mm or maybe 2 mm, however the thickness you need it. This level should come. There should be this level, and the wood should, it is up to you. If you need wood to be inside the resin, like I said, there are a lot of finishing. There are a lot of finishes that are done, but basically you'll understand what you are looking for. Just get rid of a layer of the surface, so that now it is all perfectly smooth. It is absolutely smooth. It should be smooth and leveled. So that CNC machine, because it is a machine, it does the job very perfectly. First you have to CNC it on the bottom side, so that then the straightness is achieved, and then they'll put it then they'll then you ask them to do the upper part, the top layer. So just remember CNC, everything you have to do both the sides. The finishing has to be done from both the sides. With CNC, do the bottom layer first, CNC the bottom layer first, and then the top layer. So that will give you accurate finishing. Secondly, if you are not going for a CNC machine, ask your carpenters to do it. They will be having these tools. Tell them to do the sanding. Sanding, because they usually do it. It's same like doing the furnitures and all. So basically they will just smooth it. Just get your table into a level. There will not be humps and everything. It will be perfectly in level. They'll do it. Tell them to sand and give it to you. Just do the sanding. Sandingly basically, and then obviously then I'll tell you what is sanding so that you know.